I will talk about HIV pre-exposure prophylaxis or PrEP as an essential, safe, and effective prevention tool for sexual health. PrEP relies on the use of antiretroviral molecules, the combination of tenofovir, emtricitabine, TDF-FTC, or tenofovir, alafenamide, emtricitabine, TAF-FTC, two nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, are the currently only treatments approved in this indication. Depending on countries, PrEP can be prescribed as a continuing prophylactic drug, one tablet a day, or on the month, or even driven prophylactic drug before the sexual behavior and after sexual misbehavior. Two tablets before, one tablet 24, one tablet 48 hours after sexual risk. The rationale of PrEP is explained by the four major clinical trials on PrEP. IPREX study. The IPREX study was a study the efficacy of PrEP was 44% for the patient with a good compliance. The reduction of risk was 90%. The second study was the PROD study. In the PROD study, the efficacy of PrEP was 86%, and finally, the French Hyper-Gay study was 86%, but in patients with a good compliance, it was a risk reduction at 97%. In the majority of clinical trials, compliance with PrEP was a major efficacy factor. PrEP works if you take it. Provided good compliance, all these clinical trials prove that oral PrEP is effective in the different populations, the patients, women, men, with a high effectiveness between 86 and 99%. WHO recommends prescribing PrEP to all individuals at major risk of HIV infection. That is to say, all this population, people belonging to a population group with an HIV incidence higher of 3%. The International AIDS Society suggested that in 2014, using a lower incidence threshold will define the substantial risk of HIV infection, that is to say, 2%. An increasing number of countries are adopting policies endorsing PrEP for HIV prevention. A global review found that 40 countries have incorporated PrEP into the policies or the guidelines by the end in 2018. The use of PrEP has grown substantially over the time, particularly among MSM in high-income settings where PrEP was introduced early on, as well among other priority populations in low and middle-income settings. The USA authorized PrEP in 2012. PrEP was authorized in France in 2016. France offered full control form of PrEP and then was followed by other countries worldwide. PrEP is best viewed not as a standalone product, but as a prevention option that needs to be provided alongside and together with other prevention methods, such as behavioral interventions, increasing HIV and STI testing, or the promotion of common use vaccination to talk about sexual disorders, sex practice, inquire about the substance use and its effects on sex, and then refer the patient to the specialist. In that sense, PrEP provides multiple HIV prevention options. PrEP reduces one's risk of HIV infection and may have a positive impact on sexual health and well-being. This is important, and it could lead to an increase in PrEP uptake and may serve as a mediating factor to ensure appropriate use. The PrEP may help improve sexual health and prevent the secondary transmission of HIV and STIs. Preview is an observational study sponsored by the French Research Agency. Preview is designed to demonstrate a 15% in new HIV detection among study participants using DEDI or ED PrEP. Preview actually enrolls 3,057 HIV negative individuals, largely MSM, but including transgender men and women, heterosexual men and women, sex workers, migrants in Ile-de-France, Paris region. Prevenir is one of the largest observational studies that seek to better understand PrEP in Denver in high risk zone. An interim analysis was presented in July 2019 at the International AIDS Conference. Among the participants, 52 PrEP on a daily basis, and 50% chose ED PrEP. There are two HIV infections in the event-driven PrEP group. In participants who can discontinue PrEP and no HIV infection in the daily group. An important observation in prevention was that 20% of participants also used condom. After review this French results, the WHO had recommended to include PrEP as an option of event-driven dosing for men who have sex with men, since ED PrEP data limited in other populations, such as transgender women and people having heterosexual sex, and for women showing lower coverage of sex acts, than baby dosing, ED PrEP dosing is not commonly recommended for other population groups. Daily oral PrEP is still recommended for all people at risk of HIV, including MSM. Yearly, Ile-de-France, Paris region, deals with 50% of new HIV infection in the country. Target PrEP users is 32,000 MSM in France, about 50,000 in Ile-de-France in the next years. That is to say, 60,000 consultations. In this slide, you can see the activities of currently on PrEP in 2018. Here, you have the number of patients in PrEP follow-up and the number of patients HIV positive on PrEP. The HIV contamination on the PrEP are rare. As a result of PrEP implementation in France, in October 2019, by the first time, there was informed a diminution of new HIV cases between MSM and between 2017 and 2018. Presently, Regional Health Agency, the Ile-de-France, has commissioned to the Corevi to work on PrEP. With the action comes fixed in the second semester of 2019, with objective harmonious practice on PrEP, accompany the actors on PrEP prescription, mobilize new actors to ensure a better supply of PrEP initiation and follow-up, sharing the PrEP data in the country. To get PrEP in France, the patient make an appointment in a hospital or in one STD and HIV clinic. Now, I would like to tell you how I work in PrEP consultation. PrEP consultation is one of the many activities at Air Cambry Monroe Hospital. First, the patient calls. I send him or her a prescription by email for screening STIs and also an epidemiological quiz. The first consultation takes place 7 to 10 days after the scan. I make sure that there are no signs of primary infection in case the STIs, I treat them, and I prescribe prophylactic vaccination as appropriate. I prescribe PrEP if it is necessary, and finally, I prescribe the lab for the next consultation. the second consultation takes place 4 weeks later, and I do the same activities than the month zero. In every visit, one page report by AIDS, a French association, is offered for all the patients. As you can see, PrEP prescribing is ampler. I use this media for communicating with the patient, both the staff, WhatsApp, and Twitter. In conclusion, PrEP has a positive effect in HIV epidemic and is an additional option in the context of combination HIV prevention. Is an essential, safe, and effective prevention tool for sexual health. Is integrated into HIV prevention programs, policies, and services. Improving accessibility to PrEP is one mission for the coalition. PrEP works, therefore, we believe in it. Thank you very much. Muchas gracias por su presencia. Y follow us on Twitter. Gracias.